Good morning, everyone. So thanks a lot for joining today's webinar. I see that there are quite a lot of people connected, which is very good. I am Sara Gravelli from Trusted Services, and I'm the outreach manager for the BlueBRIDGE project, which has organized this webinar. I'll say just a couple of words for those who are not familiar with BlueBRIDGE. BlueBRIDGE is an Horizon 2020 project which delivers web-based applications, what we call virtual research environments, to serve specific communities and support them in addressing specific challenges related to the ecosystem approach to fisheries domain, the maritime spatial planning domain in the education area, and also challenges related to the aquaculture sector, which is the topic of today's webinar. The first part of the webinar will be dedicated to the presentation of the tools developed by what we call the Blue Economy Team, which is composed by three main organizations which are experts in developing tools for aquaculture: the University of Athens, I2S, which is a Greek high-tech private company specialized in delivering software technology that helps businesses become more competitive, and Site, another small company working in the domain of ICT systems engineering, research and consulting. In the second part of the webinar, we will address all your questions. So to pose a question, please use the question box function that you have in the GoToWebinar user panel. We will address the questions at the end, but please feel free to post them even during the presentation. The slides and the recording of the webinar will be made available afterwards. Okay, I'm now glad to introduce today's speakers, starting from Erasimos Antzoulatos. Erasimos is a data analyst at I2S, specializing in computational intelligence methods and their application to data mining and knowledge discovery. The second speaker is Haralampos Dimitrakopoulos, which is an information technology consultant at Site, bringing to BlueBRIDGE his expertise on the implementation of techno-economical tools for aquaculture management. And last but not least, Panayota Kolsida, a computer science researcher and software engineer at the University of Athens and Athena Research Center. Yota has more than 10 years of experience in data and metadata management and in geospatial multi-factor optimization and alerting platforms. I'll stop here and I pass the floor to Erasimos.
Good afternoon. I'm Erasimos Antzoulatos, and with colleagues Haralampos and Yota, are going to present the Blue Economy New Generation Tools for Aquaculture. In this webinar, we will discuss about the BlueBRIDGE project, some challenges in aquaculture, and BlueBRIDGE solution. And we are focusing on blue economy tools for performance evaluation, benchmarking, and decision making in aquaculture for strategic investment analysis and scientific planning alerting. And also, we are going to present a geo-analytics platform. And we conclude by highlighting some benefits of the community. But what is a BlueBRIDGE project? It is a European Horizon 2020 project, which aims to provide tailored services bridging three heterogeneous domains, the aquaculture, the fisheries, and the scientific research domain, in one common and collaborative and cooperative environment. The aquaculture sector, in recent studies of FAO, claims that it is one of the biggest food producing sector, and also another remarkable conclusion is that aquaculture share in global supply forecast to increase continuously, and will be contributed equal amounts with fisheries by 2030, as shown in this figure. However, the major challenges that have to be addressed. The aquaculture sector will be financially maintainable if expenses will be reduced and the productivity will be increased. Secondly, high quality food and the animal welfare should be ensured. And at the same time, we need to take under consideration the environmental concerns. Aquafarmer producers need to handle with the issue concerning how to improve the productivity and the profitability of their farms, and simultaneously this progress should be sustainable and environmental friendly. So at this point the BlueBRIDGE coming the BlueBRIDGE which provide innovative data services to all the stakeholders of the aquaculture sector. Our goal is to support aquaculture companies to maximize the growth, reduce the cost, and minimize the impact of the environment. Investors to identify efficiently strategic locations of interest and select most profitable investments. Governments and environmental agencies to evaluate the current situation and define policies. Researchers of different scientific fields to comprehend the aquaculture's operations, cooperate and generate new knowledge, and evaluate the practical indicators of aquafarm performance. So, at this point, we are going to be more practical and see how blue economy tools support aquafarming. First of all, we provide tools to aquafarmers to be enabled to perform evaluation of their farms. Our goal is to provide tools to create machine learning models in order to estimate key performance indicators such as biological feed conversion rate, feeding rate, and mortality rate by the standing of historical sampling data. We have developed two tools to achieve this goal. First is a setup site in which aquafarmers can define the site, given some specific environmental characteristics. And the second tool is to set up model to upload the data and generate the models. Going a step further, we provide an innovative tool called the what-if analysis. Using these tools, aquafarmers can create accurate and feasible production plans, and also they have the opportunity to benchmark their performance against the competition. Let me show you a simple example how aquafarmers can use these tools. Let us assume that we are farm managers and we want to evaluate our sites. First of all, we need to use the setup site tool and define each site if they are not available to the system. We define the site by giving some environmental characteristics of the site and its location. Then we collect the data from the samplings and provide it to the system using the setup model tool. And then we create a production model using this data. The third step is to make an hypothesis, create a what-if scenario, and then we can evaluate the results by assess the vital performance indicators, and also we have the opportunity to benchmark our performance against the competition. Of course, this process can go back and create a new site and or create a new model or a scenario, and then compare the results of each scenario in terms of the performance indicators. Here we can see how a user can set up a site. The environment is user-friendly and easy to handle. a user need to define the average temperatures per month and click on a blue balloon. Users can navigate through the Google map in order to find the location of the site. Here is a screen that a user can see when he wants to create a model. We need to define the site and the species that model refers to, and also we need to upload the dataset, the sampling dataset, and another dataset that contains the weight categories that he wants to use. And then click on Save and Generate Model. The process is starting and create a model. In this screen, a user can define a hypothesis, a conditions of hypothesis, and make a what if scenario. First of all, he needs to define the model that he wants to use, and then define the conditions. First, the initial number of fish that stock, the initial fish weight, the stocking date, and the target date. Using the model, the system make the estimations of life-to-date indicators that you can see in the top left list. And the system estimates the life-to-date growth, life-to-date specific growth rate, life-to-date biological and economical FCR, and mortality. Also, it provides interactive graphs for FCR, monthly feed consumption, and weight. At this point, I want to explain why you can see two lines. The blue line is the global model. When the user define a hypothesis, the system starts a back-end process hidden from the users. In this process, the system collects all the similar sites in terms of environmental characteristics with the site of interest, and from the data and models that we have already created, we produce another model that we mention as a global model. And the same hypothesis tested to the global model and the model for the production of an aquafarm. And we produce results from a global model and the aquafarm. And in this way, you can compare the performance. At this point, we continue with Haralbos to present you the techno-economic model.
Hello, everybody. Haralbos Dragopoulos speaking from site. After Gerasimos presented the performance model, we can see now, we can ask ourselves if we can evaluate the economic performance of our sites. So the model's aim, the techno-economic model aim, is to provide economic and financial metrics, is to aid in the decision procedure of developing and operating an aqua farm for the aqua manager, and it is optional to utilize the results from the production model that Erasmus presented you before. And we say that this is optional because this is one of the key innovative characteristics of BlueBRIDGE project, that you can use each tool by itself or all together. So let's see what it's all about. You can picture the techno-economic model in five blocks, and you can see we have at start the aquafarm definition, where you select what kind of species, cages, nets, and anchors you may have on your aquafarm. This moves on to the technology definition, and here you can say how long your key components will live in the aquafarm, and you manage the shopping list. After that, we have the economics definition, and all these blocks fit the techno-economic model, which consumes the data and gives us a set of indicators such as IRR and NPV, net present value, and we will see later on all these indicators. We also have a part of a social environmental impact that alters a bit our economics definition and alters directly our NPV function, and we can see later on what it's all about. So on this slide you can see the social and environmental monetization models. The aim of these models is to conceptualize and monetize the social and environmental impact of an aquaculture, so we can manage the data and have a value for that. We try to combine social and environmental impact with our techno-economic and the production model Gerasimos showed you before. In our attempt, we consider data and computational resources that we have at reach, and in that way, we distinguish between private and social cost and benefits. By private, we mean all the costs and benefits that apply to the aquafarm as a sole unit, and social, we mean all the environment surrounding the aquafarm. So, we try to incorporate social costs and benefits in our private function, in our aquafarm function. So now we can have a feel of our tool. You can see here at the top of this window we have three columns. At the first column you can see we have to select a production model, a fish species, the maturity time. The maturity time is our estimation of the time in months that our fish will be at a sellable state. We have the aquafarm offshore checkbox. This means that if an aquafarm is far away from shore, we will probably need to create an auto-feeding machine, to buy an auto-feeding machine for our architecture. So this is substantial. This is a significant cost, so we have to use it. In the second column, you can see a set of rates. We have the tax rate by which our earnings are taxed. We have the discount rate, which is used for the NPV function. We have the price inflation rate, which is used for the price inflation of key components, for our cages or whatever. And we have the third column, is a price column. We have the estimation we give the tool for a feed price, fry price, and the possible selling price, and after that we perform our estimation analysis. So after we click on the perform estimation analysis, we have a set of tabular data beneath. You can see the two indicators in the screen, the net present value and the internal rate of return. If the net present value is positive, the whole project is feasible. If it's negative, it's not feasible. In the next tab, you can see we have a graph. It is a detailed analysis. By red line you see the expenses, with the green you can see the income, and you have some financial metrics, earnings before interest, taxes, depreciation, amortization, and earnings before interest after taxes. You can see the last two lines are very close to each other because they have a small difference between them. So the next tab, you can see the cumulative profit and loss. You can read it like this. If it is, if the blue line is over the zero line, you have profit. If it is below, you do not have. So in this project, the estimation is that the profit begins after the 2024 year. In the next tab, you can see the yearly net profit margin. You read this graph like this. You can imagine that the yearly net profit margin is the way that each new euro, each new currency unit you might have, affects the overall project. So, and in the last tab, we have the table view of the data, so that the user can see the actual numbers behind all these graphs and use it otherwise in his Excel or whatever. You can also save the search, and you can select a different production model if you want afterwards. So, I think that is all for me, and we can move on to the next presentation.
Hello, my name is Panayota Kolsitha, and I will now talk about another tool that is called the geo-analytics platform, and is a bit different because it's not specific for the aquaculture domain, but fits very well in cases that affects the aquaculture community. So I will start with the challenge. What is the challenge we would like to solve here? We would like to support investors to make efficient identification of strategic locations of interest and select the most profitable investments they want to make. In order to address this challenge, we created and developed the geo-analytics platform. The geo-analytics platform is an open spatial planning platform that supports intelligent identification of areas to switch various needs. These various needs could come from investors for that seek maximization of investments, from scientists seeking locations of socio-economic environmental interest, or policymakers seeking effects of choices on the industry. All of this can be supported by the geo-analytics platform. What are the benefits of using this platform? The geo-analytics platform is a scalable, high-performance open-source collaborative analysis tool. It offers visualization and management of geospatial information like other GIS tools. It supports various needs and through the extensibility capabilities and the plugin system that has been implemented, and this applies to different domains. And it's also an interoperable system because it implements open standards and protocols from the OGC, that is the Open Geospatial Consortium world. And finally, it enhances the collaboration through project sharing facilities, where users can work on the same project and perform analysis of specific algorithms. So how does the geo-analytics platform fits in the aquaculture case? What we can solve, for example, is that we can perform a spatial analysis for a specific area to predict the productions in terms of the key performance indicators that had been presented before by Gerasimos, such as the biomass of an aquaculture site. And to do this, we use and exploit environmental and global historical production data. Using these data sets, we can identify several locations that have the most profitable for investing a new aquaculture site in this specific area. I will now present you some. I will now show you some screenshots from the tool. You can see here that you work on a specific project that is called demo project, and you have the decision support system. And if you select an area, which is the yellow rectangle, you can then execute any of the available algorithms, like the CBAS total biomass estimation. You can run this function, and then you will get back the result, where the result is a new geospatial layer. Now you can see it's styled in red dots. And if you click on the dots, you will find what is the biomass that it will probably have in this site. And then the aquaculture manager can decide if he will move on with this investment or not. So here you can see the result for this specific location. Now I will say some more words regarding the tool. The tool is split into different views. We have the administration view, which is aimed for the administration user, and it allows to import new data, upload algorithms for execution. These algorithms can be very generic because you upload algorithm using the Java code, and you can and these algorithms can work on any domain, as I said before, and you can manage there the available geospatial layers and data sets, so that the end users then can select any of them and work on them. I will show you some more screenshots from the tool. You can see here that we have the import data function. We support a save file import, or we support import from web feature services, or also you can directly import tabular data. For example, data sets coming from Eurostat can be used and imported from this tool. In addition, you can see and manage all the available geospatial layers through this tab. You can see here that we have already uploaded several data sets. They have a description, they have a specific styles on how they will be visualized in the map, and several other attributes. This is for the administration tool, and now I will move to the end user interface, which is for end users. In this view, you can perform analysis execution, you can view the results, you can visualize any of the available geospatial layers using the map and based on the style the administrator has defined before. And you can use, and users can collaborate through project facilities where a user can create a new project and can decide to share this project with other users and perform the same analysis on the selected layers based on the same project. I will also show you now some more screenshots. You can see this, this view that you showed also before, where the layers are visualized in the map. And on the right side, you can have you can see all the available functions that can be used for executing the algorithm. In addition, you can see here how the users can create a new project. They select a specific area, then they move forward. They decide which over from the available layers want to include in this project based on what the analysis they want to perform. And in the final step, they can decide if they want to share this project with other users or no. If the project is going to be shared, then the other users are notified for this project and they can perform the same analysis based on the same selected layers. And this enhances the collaboration in the community. That was all about the tool. Now, what were the benefits of the community for all the tools that have been presented? From me and the presenters before. We provide a variety of services for the blue economy to the aquaculture sector for production models to assess performance, the techno-economic analysis, and the last one that it was the spatial investment analysis for aquaculture sites. With these tools, you can increase the productivity and profitability of aqua farms. In addition, seamless access to heterogeneous data set is provided through the set of tools without the user need to know what is the data type or the format of the data sets. And finally, we provide cooperative training environments through the dedicated virtual research environment, which is the way the Blue Project project offers its tools, as Sarah introduced in the beginning. If you are interested in exploiting our tools, you can find dedicated virtual research environments for common for training activities, and you can sign up in using the Aquaculture Training Lab. In the Aquaculture Training Lab virtual research environment, both the production aquaculture production tools and the techno-economic analysis tool are available for exploitation, or you can sign up in the SIASPA virtual research environment where you could find and exploit the geo-analytics platform. In general, please visit our BlueBRIDGE gateway in order to find more interesting virtual research environments to access and more interesting tools. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. I think it was a very interesting presentation, so I would like to thank you on behalf of all the participants. Now I think that we can open the floor to the discussion. So we have already received some questions, so I'm going to read the first question from Elena Samara. I think the first question is for Erasimos. And Elena asks, the models are available for fish only. What about sea urchins or similar animals?
Yes, I think we can extend easily the tools in order to cover these needs. But if the user provides the data set having the indicators that we want to estimate, we can use this tool in order to create models for other species.
Okay, thank you so much. Then we have two questions for Harlampos. So the first one is from Carlos Espinal, and the question is, are there any other OPEX elements that can be included in the techno-economic model aside from feed and fingerlings?
As is now, the feed price and the fry prices, and the prices that we use as estimates. But if there is a need, we can implement something different to extend the needs of the audience. But I think these prices can create useful results so that the aquafarmer or the manager can relate to his research or to his practices.
Okay, and then we have another question always related to your presentation that says, can I print reports of the analysis? What does saving workspace mean?
Yes, I saved some time from the audience by not having screenshots from the safe workspace. You have a virtual folder, you can save the files, you can print it, you can take it out in Excel and various formats. So yes, they can be definitely printed afterwards.
Okay, then a couple of questions for Jota. Digio-spatial layer visualization allows to view the layers. How about exporting the results?
For the end users, you cannot export the results, but in the administrator's view, you can export the results in shapefile format.
Okay, and the next question.
The results, just Sarah, let me.
Yep. Sorry.
Check something more. The result of the execution analysis is a new geospatial layer that is stored into the platform, and then you have this, the save options through the administrator's interface. Thank you.
Okay, and then another question was, how can you view the used functions? How can you add new functions in what language?
Yes, the used functions can be, all the functions can be seen again through the administrator's interface, where currently we have decided that users with specific role having access to this view can upload new functions. You can view there, and then usually you upload a Java plugin, you use Java code to upload the functions, and also you can you provide a JavaScript for the part of the visualization of the function, how it will be visualized and what layers is it going to ask for as input. Because we use this pluggable system in order to be very flexible, and for this reason, for the, because of the flexibility, can be applied to any domain.
Okay. Then we have another question about how reliable are the growth model you use with fish growing at different rates or receive food of different quality?
How reliable are the growth model you use with fish growing at different rates or receive food of different quality? I think this can use both our answers, but the growth model has a, the growth model, as far as I know, has a distinct set of feed. You select the quality of the fish, the feed, right?
Yes.
And this is fixed. So here, if we have a growth rate at different rate of the receiving of food, based on the model, it's based on the model, I suppose.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, based on
using the first tools, you define a new model, and this model comes as input to the techno-economic analysis tool.
Yes.
So if you define a new model, then it can be used in the techno-economic analysis tool.
Yes, and the model comes from the data that the user feed to the system. So.
Okay, sorry about that. So, if I understand correctly, the user here might want to have a sensitivity analysis on the rate of the growth of the fish. So, if he creates two or three different models for the same site, he can use it for the...
Yes, of course. So, the result.
That's the way you can do the sensitivity analysis on this project.
Okay. The next question is, would these be available in portable machines like smartphones?
Regarding the geo-analytics platform, it has been designed as a responsive web application. That means that it works well in tablets, but for mobile phones, the screen size is not... It's not the best to use because you won't be able to visualize in a nice way the tool. Yes. But for tablets, it works fine. But it is a responsive web app. We don't plan to create at the moment a mobile app. For the other tools, I assume it is the same.
Yes.
Okay. Then a question for you, Yota. Do you also provide the geospatial data, or do we need to source elsewhere? If you own the data, is there any quality control performed in it to ensure its reliability?
For the moment, in the virtual research environment where we had deployed this tool, we have also selected a set of data sets that that are good and of good quality for our use case for the aquaculture that I said in my presentation. But in general, when someone deploys this tool independent of the BlueBRIDGE project and the use cases we had to solve and to address, he can upload his own data sets and he should select the data sets. In our case, we have used data sets coming from Eurostat, data sets coming from Copernicus, from Natura, and other reliable sites. And in addition, we are using the production model, the global production model provided by our colleagues from I2S. But this is also for the Blue Project case. In general, the platform comes empty, let's say, and the administrator should feed them with their data depending on the cases that they want to address. And the domain.
Thanks, Yota. The next question is for all. How much do these tools cost? Interesting question.
In the context of the project, someone can exploit the tools using the virtual research environments, as I showed you in my last slide. You can go and explore the Aquaculture Training Lab VRE, where the tools are there and free, and you can exploit them. If you want to get the tools and deploy it in your own machines and exploit them, we have not yet decided on the cost and, most importantly, on the license of the tool.
Okay, very
good. But
clear.
We are going to provide an exploitation model after the end of the project, or just before the end.
Then we have a question, I think, for Halarampos. The aim is to combine and monetize social and environmental impacts. Which environmental impacts are considered in the model presented by Yota, and how data are collected? I think it's for you.
Both, okay. I think it's more for Yota, this answer, this question. So, what environmental data do you have in the geoanalytic model? You have several layers, right?
Regarding the geoanalytics platform for the aquaculture use case, we have taken into account the marine protected areas where aquaculture sites cannot be deployed there. So in our analysis, we don't choose these locations because we perform we don't do a detailed analysis, but we select locations based on the algorithms and based on some assumptions we do. So we don't use the marine protected areas, or we don't use places that are not allowed to create aquaculture sites. And this is how we take into account the environmental data. But for the techno-economic analysis tool, I think it's a bit different.
Okay, in the techno-economic analysis tool, we have the cost and benefits that apply to the entity function. But in general, we select the sites by the temperature, the salinity, these environmental values. So this is how we select the site, if it is okay to build an aqua farm. And from the techno-economical model, we make a more quantitative value for the impact in numbers on our model. I hope we answered the question.
Yeah, Giovanna, let us know if we answered your question, or let us know if you have any other, if you want more detail. Okay, then we have another question. How did you compute the costs of an aquaculture farm when moved offshore? What do you believe that are the next steps to improving such cost estimations?
Okay, when the aquafarm is offshore, for instance, we have built our case on an aquafarm that is about 1,000 tons yearly production. So this is how we use it. And if it is offshore, we create, as I said before, an auto-feeding machine that might cost, it is a significant cost, and we use it. What are the next, how do you compute the costs? What do you believe that are the next steps to improve some cost estimations? Okay, such cost estimations could improve if we use some area data. For instance, in a later model, we might use how much the oil price is on the area, so that you can fine-tune the cost of the aquafarm for moving the boats on the aquafarm, or for the machines working, or whatever, or the per capita income or the per capita income in the area, so that you know how much an employee costs you in that area. So that are our next thoughts for the model.
Okay, then we have a question related to the previous one, related to the we already talked about the cost of the application, but William asks, what is the accuracy of the application?
For which tool, and what does it he mean by
yeah. Maybe William, if you can write a detail more the question, we will come back to this question later. Let's move to the next one. Can your tools also gather information on disaster impacts and assess damage after natural disasters?
Regarding the geo-analytics tool, as I replied before, in order to take these things into account, you need to create a custom analysis execution algorithm where data sets for disaster impacts can be used in the algorithm execution, and it will be taken into account so that the spatial analysis could use the location based also on this information. We have built this tool in order to be very generic and very pluggable so that it can fit different domains and different use cases. So I believe that this could be done through the geo-analytics platform as long as we have data sets available regarding the disaster impacts.
Okay, thank you. The next question is about, you mentioned that the global model is being built taking into account similar sites with environmental characteristics to the sites inserted. Are these just based on environmental characteristics or also taking into account other variables?
Yes, for the moment we designed only environmental characteristics of the sites, but we can extend in order to take consideration other factors.
Okay, perfect. Another question is about, is the tool support any languages and currencies?
Okay, as you see in the price area, you would not define the currency. You can use the numbers and you can say this is dollars, this is euro, but it's free, currency free for us. It's just numbers. So the languages for now is English, I think.
Yes.
Also in Greek. The menu is in English. So the language is in English and the currency is currency free. Okay.
Perfect. And then we go back to the question of William asking what is the accuracy, because he's referring to social, economical, and environmental. And he asks if outside of the application, how this accuracy helps in the permit process.
Okay. In our attempt, we are trying to build a tool to evaluate the area you want to, you are already probably developing your site, or you want to develop a site. So obviously you will not have a very fine-tuned results and a very fine-tuned accuracy, because this costs a lot, and companies do it in a very customized way. So we have a more generic approach. The feel of the project and the overall tools is to create some kind of a benchmark for the area, and you can have some values so that you know where is the benchmark of the area, not a very fine-tuned. We are not very fine-tuned, so we do not have a big accuracy, but you can have a feel of the site. And if you compare the results from one site with the results from another site, you can create the feel. So if you know the results for one site for sure, by comparing the results of our tool, you can have a feel for the other side.
Perfect. I hope we answer the question of William. William, let us know. Okay, Francisco goes back to the question related to offshore farms, and he says, thank you for your previous answer. Still related to offshore farms, the automated feeding machines would require power. Are your cost estimations considering a power generation system, such as diesel engine, to power the system or power transmissions from land?
Okay, we have a bulk estimation of the cost of operation of these machines. I think on our model was a diesel engine, but I'm not sure, because I just had a bulk analogy of the operation cost for the test scenario of 1,000 ton production per year aquafarm. So I have it on a percentage, so I do not have a I do not know if it was on diesel load or an electricity line otherwise. So.
Okay. And I think we have one left question. So Francisco says thank you. The final question that I left at the end is, what is next for the project?
Well, sky is the limit for us, but we hope your questions feed us with new insight for our next project. Or this.
Okay. Regarding the BlueBRIDGE project and how you could exploit the tools, we have some more months for the project before it's end, but stay tuned, visit our website, visit our gateway, and you will get informed on how you can exploit our tools also after the end of the project. And thank you.
Yeah. And there is still another remark from William that as it's very intrigued by the cost, is asking if there is any academic class version.
As far as I know, we have, yeah. You can enter the Aquaculture Training Lab. The link is offered in the PowerPoint you will receive later on. This is it. Okay.
Exactly. You will. I can complement the answer. So if you click on the links that we have in the presentation, you can access actually the tool and try them and use them. And then if you want more information, you can contact us at any time and we can answer all your questions. Okay. I think that we are, questions are over. We are receiving lots of thank you via the chat. So I would like to thank again all the participants. That were really quite a lot. And I would like to thank again our speakers. It was very nice learning from you. And as I said before, the slides and the recording will be available very soon. Thanks a lot.
Thank you
all for participating.
Goodbye. Goodbye.